So let's use this model of the Earth. And let's enlist the help of a friend.
You're beginning to believe the illusions we're spinning here. You're beginning to think that the tube is reality and that your own lives are unreal.
Hey, man. You ever looking to fly? Hey, man. You ever looking to fly?
That stuff is... That stuff is flat.
Well, if you want the truth, go to God. Go to your guru. Go to yourself. Because that's the only place you're ever going to find any real truth. We deal in illusions, man. None of it is true. Well, if you want the truth, none of it is true. You're beginning to believe the illusions we're spinning here. You're beginning to think that the tube is reality and that your own lives are unreal. Go to God. The illusions we're spinning here. Go to your guru.
This world is not what you think it is. This world is not what you think it is.
Go, go.
What do you want?
We'd like you to help plan the news for 1973.
Come again?
Plan the news for 1973. We've only roughed out the news for 1973. Nothing's been given the go-ahead yet, but this is the kind of thing we have in mind.
Today, April 14, 1973. First historic pictures by Radstar of the combined U.S.-Russian landing on the moon. Shown here are Majors Webb and Mikhailovich taking their first steps into the unknown, firing their retro rockets to land their spacecraft on the dust-covered surface. A comforting note for us stay-at-homes, both the Pentagon and the Kremlin have announced that the moon has no strategic value.
A comforting note for us to stay at home. I can't show you any film on this next model. We haven't photographed it yet. But this is the way it will sound.
June the 22nd, 1973. The State Department releases film of the ultimate weapon, codenamed Icarus. This satellite is equipped with a solid reactor. In layman's terms, it can freeze air solid, stopping all missiles, killing all forms of life. Icarus orbits at the same speed as the Earth, can hang in position over every major city that threatens the peace-loving nations.
Rather proud of this one. Come on. Please, sit down.
September the 5th, 1973. The new phase in global warfare. War by example. At 4:32 our time, China took out the remote Indian border village of Bandar, unprotected by the Icarus network. After the first 2 5 megaton H-bombs have fallen, the nine-way hotline finally...
Switch it off. Set.
But...
this is going to happen in 1973. You're going to make this happen?
No. We're going to make models much cheaper. Then we photograph the models.
Fake newsreels?
Yes, fake newsreels. For the past 10 years, people have been looking at our fake newsreels and listening to our fake commentaries.
And they accept it for the truth. And you can do it. Stop 100 people in the street. How many of them have actually seen a missile or a satellite? They're just told they exist and they believe it.
Yes, you're getting there. I knew you would.
Well, now, the moon rocket and the satellite, that you can get away with. That's too remote for people to grasp. It's too far away. But this... I mean, you invented this village on the Indo-Chinese border.
Oh, yes.
Well, somebody could check up.
Very mountainous territory up there. There'll be no survivors in 1973. No rescue work. Radiation scare.
Yes. You can do it. This could be the news for 1973.
Not necessarily exactly like this. We only plan in detail 1 year ahead.
Oh, you only plan 1 year ahead.
Tell me, what is the news item that's bothered you the most in the past year, 1967?
Oh, well, it has to be the new American intercontinental ballistic missile, the Boy Wonder, doesn't it?
Just the one I asked him to set up for you. The new ICBM, codename Boy Wonder, with a much-talked-about Mercury warhead. I haven't any special effects up here, but perhaps with the proper sound. Blast off. And Robert Larkin, television director, high IQ, 35 years old, is scared. Scared by nothing. It doesn't work. It's a scientific impossibility. The same goes for the much talked about Mercury warhead. Perspex.
Well, if this rocket doesn't work, then the others...
They have a fireworks party at Cape Kennedy almost every other day. Well, you didn't really believe there were all these things whizzing about up there, did you? Sputniks and rockets. Astronauts crossing their legs for 8 days.
How long has this been going on?
Since Hiroshima.
And the H-bomb, you mean, that doesn't work either?
Right. Dirty.
Very, very dirty.
What was your first reaction? Relief. Oh, yes. Yes, it has to be relief. Only 12 people are allowed beyond this point. Most of them work in the photographic department, taking phony newsreel pictures of our models and processing film and so on. Sit down, please. Ah, pretty pictures from our stills department. The Boy Wonder.
Do you really think that missiles and satellites are my line of country?
No, not at all. I've only shown you the hard news. There are other things, much softer things we thought might interest you.
Well?
1973. We thought it might be time for an anti-teenage movement. A long-awaited return to maturity. Sherry. Perhaps even a religious revival.
When did it all start?
1945. You may remember the Americans let off their two atomic bombs. Well, they didn't want other people doing the same thing. I mean, you do see that, don't you?
Oh, I don't know.
You scare the people off. The Americans put it up, and the atomic bomb was halfway along the line to something much bigger, the hydrogen bomb. It didn't work. They spent 5 years in negative research.
Well, what about the Russians? They're supposed to have quite a pile of these things.
We were surprised when they started their tests. Then we got a few feelers from their Secret Service. Nowadays, we work very closely together. Oh, all these stories about spies going off to Russia. Mr. Philby, remember? Just good copy for the Sunday papers.
Good copy. Well, the Chinese. I mean, they've just announced their bomb.
Yeah, we played along with it. We recorded their phony explosion. We're rather hoping the Chinese will come along. Complete the pattern, you know.
In Vietnam, hundreds of people are being killed every week. Well, you can't do that with your models.
No. And you can't cure people of bad habits for two generations. They like to carry rifles. They like to put lines on maps. And we let them because we control the situation. There's no danger of world war. Just a simple choice for everybody. Capitalism or communism. Strawberry or vanilla. It all adds up to the same thing now we've got rid of the big bangers.
Well, how can you be sure that Johnson, Kosygin aren't working on other things? Poison gases, bacteria.
pathetic, man of your intelligence. You don't want to destroy the world, neither do I. What makes you think that presidents are different?
Well, they've made some pretty good stabs at it in the past.
There wasn't the right sort of control then. Nowadays, we know better. Politicians are easy to control. The grosser mentality boys who like to be photographed getting in and out of Daimler's in Whitehall. They come right at the bottom of our organization. A few rungs up the ladder, there are the people in the top secret factories. Just those in a position to know they're making weapons that don't really work.
There must come a time when somebody wants to use one of those weapons. I mean, somebody is standing there with a finger on the button.
Well, that's the beauty of it. Nobody presses the button. We control all the crises. We build them up and we shut them down.
We? Again?
Yeah, I'm coming to that. Near the top of the hierarchy, there are the economists, top civil servants, top brass in the military, those men who are supposed to view the nuclear tests and so on. And above them, CWNS.
Right at the top. Classified World News Service. Just who the hell are you?
It's obvious, isn't it? Just a few, just a very few of the top people in communications in every major country in the world.
Oh, you mean you run all these magazines?
No, of course not. We just get them to take some of our copy every week. Television is much more important to us. It all happens so quickly.
Now, you say you can put out what pictures you like on television. Doesn't anybody try to stop you?
No, nobody wants to. 99.386% of the population wouldn't believe this conversation. And the rest are working for us. And they're the top minds, the really responsible people. They know they're guaranteeing the lives of their grandchildren the only foolproof way.
Scaring the hell out of their grandchildren. Well, I won't buy it.
You must admit there has to be some kind of control in this world of ours. Look at this. And remember that one quarter of the world is starving. There are the full bellies and the empty bellies. Some of the empty bellies carry rifles. Well, we full bellies are getting a bit flabby. We're not very good with rifles anymore, so we've devised two ways to keep the empty bellies under control. One of them is this fictitious hydrogen bomb we've talked about. The other one is money. Enough money to fill some of the empty bellies and put a hopeful smile on the faces of the others. A great wall of money all around Britain. And it's no secret that the British economy is in trouble at the moment. So we have to put that right too, to stay alive. We have to control the people in this country. Scare an ostrich, buries its head in the sand. You scare a hedgehog, it rolls itself up into a ball. When a woman's frightened, she goes out and buys herself a hat.
You mean you scare us so that we'll buy more, so that money moves quicker, production moves up?
We don't say scare when we talk about human beings. We say threaten them emotionally. And there are all sorts of ways, not just the big ones like the hydrogen bomb. Overcrowd them a little with bad planning. Sell them too many motor cars. Anything to keep them a little bit removed from reality. Nowadays, people don't work for money. They work for the idea of money. They don't even love for love. They love for the idea of love. They only hate for the idea of hate. It took us 5 years to find a non-addictive drug, one we could pay off against the hard drugs. LSD.
You marketed that?
Oh, yes, of course. And for a very good reason. Some of these protest movements were getting a little bit too close to the mark. LSD gave them nice little hallucinations. Made them talk like three-year-olds. Throw flowers at policemen. Shall we talk terms?
You're not still going to ask me to work for you.
I'm afraid I've had to put all this rather bluntly. You see, there wasn't really very much time. It must be rather a shock. Most people realize that the world is controlled from about six big cities. But it must be rather shocking to learn that a sixth of the world is controlled from this building.
You mean you?
Oh, no. I only rate an office on the seventh floor. There are two other offices above this one. And a giant computer system. I ought to tell you, we pay a great deal of money. We can afford to. We save such a lot on things like the national defense budget, so on. We would start you off at £250,000 a year.
No.
Rising to £1,000,000 when you make the Ministry of Morality, which I know you will.
Will you let me out of here?
One little point. I should have told you about these surgical transmitters. There's enough of this stuff inside you at this moment to kill 6 people. There's a button we can press. I'm sorry about the dramatics. Our boys call these things the oral contraceptive. Keeps them from talking too much.
So there must be one of those transmitters inside you. Who presses the button? Extra hands. All this stuff about the computer being extra hands for the men and how to control it. That machine controls you.
You start on Monday.
I wonder if you would recommend locking down schools if you had to do it all over again.
You're okay. You're not gonna get COVID if you have these vaccinations.
First of all, I didn't recommend locking anything down.
Vaccinated people do not get sick.
I recommended to the president that we shut the country down.
CDC and TSA, IRS, CIA, and that's a reason crack. SpaceX, Space Force, space is fucking fake, of course. Devon Island, it's Mars. Elon Musk is launching cars. Einstein was a queen, 2 more weeks of quarantine. Jesse Smollett, fake attack. George Floyd, swallow crack. Said he couldn't breathe at all. Overdose from fentanyl. ALC and Alex Stein. Harvick's booty is so far.
Why do we trust these liars? We must be discerning. The world's not turning, no more astronauts or wires. We are sick of these clowns, let's get this circus shut down.
Bin Laden in the sea, Robbie Packer smiling. Epstein didn't die, flight logs are classified. California communist, you said traps the list. Mask your kids, stay inside, for your health from outer high. You're all looking at bugs, world economic threats, Klaus Schwab, Castro. I'm Justin Trudeau. Psychos, the elite, Bill Gates are tracking me. Biotech, Moderna, Pfizer, AstraZeneca.
Why do we trust these liars? We must be discerning, cause the world's not turning. No more astronauts or wires. This world is breaking, you know, and now it's time we are frozen.
9/11, no planes, another tree, another day. Noonan 7 falling from the plane, they're calling. Passport found in the stream. Lucky Larry Silverstein moving like a slot machine. Shanks to a red pill. Rumsfeld mess up. That's what hit the Pentagon. Where is all the footage gone?
Why do we trust these liars? You must be discerning, cause the world's not turning. No more astronauts or wires. We are sick of these clowns. Let's get this circus shut down.
Climate change, MSN, selling fear, CNN, moonshot, space walk, Alfred, Dalton. All the astronauts who died have
the tree, still alive. Challenge to a master plan. Buzz all dreamers drunk again.
We have moon rocks.
Petrified.
That sucks.
Yellow light.
The rockets fly.
CGI.
Planet stone.
CGI.
The ISS.
RBS.
Is that fucking flat?
Actually, yes.
Not dinosaurs.
Ace, of course.
I can't take it anymore. Concerning that's a building is burning, maybe come and call these liars. They deserve a takedown for saying we go around, 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 around. Why do we trust these liars? We must be discerning, cause the world's concerning. No more astronauts or wires. This world is faking, you know. Now it's time we expose it. Trust these liars. You must be discerning, cause the world's not turning. No more astronauts or wires. This world is breaking, you know. Now it's time we expose.